Correct me if I'm wrong, but it's my understanding that in discussing or coming up with a recommendation, or even the Board of Commissioners coming up with a vote, that we're not supposed to take into consideration whether there's going to be a lawsuit or not. It's my understanding that consideration of a lawsuit should not enter into a fact of whether we should be making our decision. You know, I've heard people around say, well, we really better not do that because we might get sued. And it's my understanding that that's not right.
Right.
Can you weigh in on that, or am I?
Well, yeah, absolutely. I mean, I think that's a fair question. I mean, should litigation dictate your land use? If I can frame it that way, just for a second, litigation dictate your land use? Should the threat of litigation dictate your land use? The answer is no. The threat of litigation should not dictate your land use. Now, when the governing authority, if they have a concern about potential litigation and they want to speak to me privately about it, am I going to give them some guidance? Yes. Should it be necessarily guiding your recommendations? No, not really. Every zoning you're going to have in front of you is probably going to have a constitutional challenge letter in the file if it's being done by lawyers that do this a lot. It's not meant to be. It's not meant to be overly adversarial. It's not meant to be offensive. It's simply meant to comport with the law that says that if you don't raise certain constitutional challenges at the time or before the decision is made, they are waived. That's what that's about. So it's not an attempt to say that every time there is a zoning and there's that letter in there, that therefore a threat of litigation should guide your land use decision. Because if that was the case, if every time you got one of those letters you said, oh my goodness, this says that if we don't take this action it's going to be illegal, you'd approve every one of them, right? And that's not the rule either.